Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Hey, I have something cool to show you today. I'm here in the iTunes store. I'm going to click on podcast. And then up here in the search, I want you to type, this is all one word, on, home, and office. Click enter, and you're going to see a brand new podcast. This is put out by Q, Pearson, my publisher. And what you're going to find there is several different podcasts of me. They're Mr. Excel podcasts, basically, but they're nice. They're in high def. We filmed these down in Virginia last year. So if you like the Mr. Excel podcast, go ahead and check this out. I think it's going to come out about once a week, although there's maybe four or five episodes out there. So another dose of Excel tips each week. Nice high def podcast kind of makes me realize that with my $30 webcam here, and nice podcast. Check it out. Okay, so yesterday we talked about how to make sure that these headings always appear. But as I reread the question, I started to realize that he might be talking about making these appear on the printed page. So that's a completely different issue. Let's take a look at this. We have titles up here in row one and headings in row three. And the person who asked the question, Smack83, said, I'm typing the headings again and again and again. And that made me think that he's typing those headings in order to get them to print. So if we're trying to make them print on the first row, you know, I have to tell you, I have this big print titles thing here, but I'm really so focused on the way we did it in Excel 2003. I always use this tiny little icon. This icon is called the Dialog Launcher, and it's a great way in Excel 2007 to go back to the old Excel 2003 dialog box. Here on the fourth tab, the Sheet tab, rows to repeat at top, we can basically just highlight rows 1 to 3, and if you want to repeat a certain column at the left, highlight column A, and when we click OK, now in the print preview, we'll see that it prints rows 1 to 3 at the top of every single page. Certainly no need to go through and reset that. Print titles, this is the new way to do it. I guess that's actually a faster way to get back to the exact same spot that I did. I wanted to show off there, though, the dialog launchers. These great little icons in the bottom of many groups and the ribbon, great way to very quickly get back to the dialog box that you know and love from Excel 2003. All right, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. Don't forget to check out the On Home and Office podcast. I'm Bill Jelen. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.